Today's guests are Robert Gallant and Marshall Button, both of the HubCap Comedy Festival fame. It's in its 18th year now. Happens in Moncton, happens in February. The roster that they speak about is very impressive. It's huge, in fact. Logistics, phenomenal. And at some point, maybe we should wake up to the economic driver it also represents. Because the business of being funny could be a growing business for New Brunswick. In the meantime, we can ask the question, where is New Brunswick's funny bone? Is it Moncton? Some say Miramichi. Who knows? Maybe you know where it is. Or maybe you have a really good joke about New Brunswick you'd like to post on our Facebook page. Either way, enjoy the conversation with Marshall and Robert. So in doing a bit of prep for the interviewing you guys, and it's raw material, it's like somebody should get hold of it. One of your sponsors is Organigram.
Absolutely.
My goodness. So, and it's the educational component you've got to identify it on your website. So how much, you know, the raw material that could grow out of that would...
Well, yeah, speaking of raw material, this is what we're giving to, what, the comedians? Yeah. That's part of their
welcome
kit. Yeah. I didn't know what it was, but I guess it's a thing... No, you put your marijuana in there and then you crash it or whatever, like to put it in. Now, I haven't had occasion to use it yet, but good on them, you know. Like the comedians, so many of them, much of their material revolves around just talking about smoking dope. So it's right, you know.
And well, and once we pass that July 1st date, we're into next year.
Yeah,
we can do a 420 show. We can do something tied in with them. And but I mean, you know, they'll be there and they do some of the education component and that stuff.
That's great.
Like in some ways, it's not just a joke because we know they've just done a huge donation in terms of dealing with, even though it's not their side of the business, but the opiate crisis.
Yep.
Like they're giving kits out to all the frontline workers that can deal with Naloxone or whatever it is and deal with that. So, I mean, it is something that they take seriously. They're being good corporate citizens.
Yeah.
And we're very happy that they're coming on board and working with us.
Well, and plus, at the Capitol Theater, we are going to pump marijuana through the air exchange
for
system.
A few extra laughs.
During the show. Yeah. So that's a new feature this year.
So get ready for the run on the munchies when people leave.
Exactly. No more Pringles left at the bar.
We'll just be out there selling chips and pop. And
But this is good to bring up because, like people being hesitant to laugh, they say, we got to start opening up a lot of conversations about all the things that are possible and good and creative and actually make you feel at home. It gives you a sense of home because everyone knows where they fit. And so when I read that, I saw Organigram, it's a comedy festival. I thought, oh, somebody's going to jump on this and have some fun running with it. But if we talk about it this way, too, it also gives context, professional, community-based, and go have your fun.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah, it's quite an operation. I did a Christmas show for them in December. And, you know, at the casino there, they had their party. And what a serious bunch of friggin' stick-in-the-mud people. Like, they really take their work very seriously. And, you know, that is a bit of a... you know, people's preconceptions, like you think if you were with a group of actors, you'd have a good time. Not.
No.
Like you want to hang out with like accountants and people who have like boring jobs in real life have more fun.
Yeah.
It's just the way it is.
Kurt Vonnegut was once quoted as saying, you want to learn to be a writer, go to an engineer's convention.
Yeah, exactly.
Be the only one of your type in that space. Previous guest on the show, Niels Riemann, talks about the growth of the cannabis industry in New Brunswick. He's on the medical side, was really looking for more cooperation from government and other businesses because in his view, if we all work together on this, New Brunswick can really make a huge leap forward in that particular sector rather than the traditional competitive method of making sure my competition does know everything I'm doing. So it might tie to some of the seriousness that
you ran
into it. And it's at the front end of a potentially big curve for all of them.
Mm-hmm.
So, anyway, I just thought Organigram, Comedy Festival.
Perfect.
Too good. Yeah. Too good.
Yeah. But we try to, with all of our sponsors, we try to make it more of a relationship, a partnership, as opposed to just here's a check.
Yes.
So, like, with our friends at BMW, they're in, but they give us cars to drive around. And it's funny, you always think, well, a vehicle's a vehicle, almost like we used to rent 7-passenger vans. But even the bigger headliners that get picked up in a really nice vehicle, they notice the difference from... They played at whatever festival down the road and they got picked up in somebody's broken down Chevette or whatever. But they're like, wow, this is really nice. Nice of, you know, so those things, but that's come from developing that relationship. So it's not just here's a check-in or whatever. We, you know, we develop the relationship. And then they're also at the Capitol shows, you know, being able to interact with people coming in and our different clients. We find different angles for them to be able to actually be part of the festival, not just a check.
Here's a check from me. So we didn't crash any BMWs yet, knock on wood, but
with all the snow, it's amazing. It's worth almost as much as my house. I'm a little nervous sometimes driving around, but
exactly. Yeah. So,
any thoughts to wrap us up?
Well, I guess the thinking being that even though this takes place in February, like we hope that we're part of creating a culture that promotes humor and laughter in people's daily lives. And it sounds a bit altruistic and aren't we great, but you know what, I was doing the State of the Province event last week in Fredericton, and you know, someone of the organizers says, oh, this government, they're very thin-skinned, you know, every time someone makes a comment we hear back, and they may not be, you know, ready to take a joke. I mean, I made my jokes anyway and they seemed to laugh, and it was fine. But I think it's when we witness what's going on south of the border, where everything is so-called fake news, you know, that everybody's an enemy if you're not just, you know, dealing with straight kind of government propaganda, which you may or may not disagree with, that it's a very healthy activity to keep people honest, to keep everybody kind of, because yes, it's funny and it's meant to laugh at, but if you really think of why you're laughing, it's because we're talking about the elephant in the room. It's because we're exposing the foibles of what some high up person may have done. And as soon as that right, you know, you can say, oh, we're a free country, we can continue to do this, but I'm not so sure now when you're starting to see some of these trends and some of these so-called big democracies that are the model of the world. So I think it's something worth keeping and treasuring.
And to follow that theme that you just pointed out, English Canada tends to adopt American values pretty quick, mm-hmm. and sort of forget Canadian values.
Yeah.
Because we're so influenced through American media. So you could argue there's been an erosion of what makes Canadian. And one of the things that makes us Canadian is how we laugh.
Yeah.
We laugh differently and have different sense of humor than the American version. So maybe humor.
But there's a reason why so many of the biggest comics in the States have been Canadians over the years too, because we're exporting that ability or right to laugh at ourselves. And so some of them may not feel as popular, but
we have that kind of outsider's view of we're the kind of sitting on top of you looking down, and we're looking, you know, through the window at you, and then all of a sudden.
But it's similar to how we always say sorry, that kind of narrative. So it might be that our sense of humor will help us remember to be Canadian while shifts in democracy and what is fake news or real news carry on in other places.
Perhaps, yeah.
Yeah, I think it comes down to, not taking ourselves too seriously. So, I mean, being able to laugh at self-deprecating humor, because we are, like you say, we always say sorry all the time because we're always, but it is about the fact that, we can look inwards and we can like, that is kind of ridiculous that I did that or said that, and be able to laugh at that. And that's, that's a big part of surviving. I think, you can be angry all the time. There's lots of people who are angry all the time. They make a living at it, but how long are they going to live? Or how are they going to, you know what I mean? Like, be able to step back and like, let's laugh at our ridiculousness. And
well, maybe if we crystal ball it 10 years from now, we'll look back at this interview and see that you two were able to put the happiness index into the matrix of whether New Brunswick's a nice place to live.
Either that or we'll be up on charges.
Yeah,
me too. That'll be us. Robert will accuse me of sexual harassment.
There you go. Yeah.
I shouldn't joke about that, but you never know.
Yeah, you never know.
No, all right.
Okay.
Good.
Yeah. Thank you. Yeah,
thanks very much.
Thank you. And thank you for watching. Be good. Have fun. Love each other.
The Dennis Report is an independent media production. To support the program, go to DennisAtchison.com and click Become My Patron on Patreon.